My name's Marietta, and this week's Aqua Tip is actually about a discussion that's been happening on Facebook about stretching in the warm-up. So, let me go through how I think about this. And look, I appreciate that there's different thought patterns, but I'm going to rationalise what I'm talking about. Firstly, in the warm-up of any land-based workouts now, there is no stretching, because research has demonstrated quite effectively that that tiny little bit of stretching that we do in the warm-up does not prepare the body, does not prepare the muscles, and certainly doesn't help warm up the body. And that's more so in the water, because the water is now making my body cold. If I was to stand any more still for any more length of time, I'm going to get much colder. Hence the reason why in aqua class, your warm-up needs to be vigorous, needs to warm up the body. Warming up. It's going to take a little bit longer than that for me to physically get warm, but my body is getting warm, and that's the sort of warm up I would do. I would never start an aqua class warming up people like this, unless the pool was of course very hot, then this might be adequate, but in normal pool temperatures, this will not warm up anybody. And that perception of warm-up has come from old school aerobic days, where you start gentle and you move up. Water is a completely different medium. So then we talk about stretching in a warm-up, and we go, well, what's the purpose behind that? Can you really get a good stretch when you're in the pool through full range of motion, and is it necessary? So going back to what I said before, there's research that determines that on land we don't use it, so why are we using it in the water? And I actually believe it's because some people are still holding on to an old belief system and haven't, you know, listened and read the research. So there was a comment about stretching the calf during a cross-country ski. Now, for me to force my heel down, because I have to, when I do a cross-country ski, my heel goes down at the front, but my heel is definitely lifted at the back. For me to push the heel down would be quite a ballistic type of stretch, something I actually prefer not to recommend, and I personally would not, because I think it's unnatural, I think it's too fast, I think the calf doesn't need it, because even in the cross-country ski, you never put your heel down anyway. So the question is, should we be doing stretching in the warm-up? My personal opinion is that we do not need it, and it shouldn't be done, certainly with a cross-country ski.